Welcome. Today we will learn to create an exam paper or a test paper in LaTeX. Here I have one folder which contains some images. I will create my main text file in this folder. So first I will open Text Studio. Then we will create a new file. Save this in the same folder. Now we will write LaTeX first command document class. And class will be exam and then document environment, begin document, end document. Inside this environment we will write the questions. For writing any question we need to use a questions environment, so just write begin questions and end questions. First use question command and then write the question. I'll give some examples. First question command and then question. Alright, so we can see here all the questions. One more question I'll write. Now this time I'll divide this question in parts. For this we need to use parts environment. Begin parts, end parts. And each part we can write with the part command and then text, okay. Any part further we can divide using sub parts environment. For writing sub part, use sub part command and then text, okay. Main question, parts, sub parts. Now I'll load some important packages. First one, font type. Second one, set space for the line spacing. Third one, graphics for the images. Next one, MES packages for the math. We can also create title using title command. Here you can also write author command if you want. I am not using. Date format we can change using date time command. Alright, we can also print name and roll number, also a small line using a rule command. In the next, we'll create instructions for the paper. For this, we can write section, subsection or sub-subsection command. I'll use sub-subsection and instructions can be given with the enumerate environment. After this we can put a horizontal line with the hrule command. This vertical white space we can remove using a vspace command. We can also print mark for each question. So after question command, in a square bracket, just write the mark, compile your file. Alright. Using choices environment, we can create multiple choice questions. So after question command, just write the question. And in choices environment, use a choice command and then write the choice. We can also generate all the choices in a single line. So for this we have to use one par choices environment, okay. Here you can see that question and all the choices are coming in the same line. Here we can leave a blank space and then we'll get all the choices in a new line, okay. Next we'll create a true false questions. First write question command, then question. For printing true false at the rightmost we can use hfill command and in the last in a round bracket just write T by F. We can also create a fill in the blank questions. First write question command, question, and leave a blank space where you want. For this you can use L dots command or rule command or fill in command. Okay, fill in command has two square brackets. In the first pair we can provide the answer, and in the second pair we can write the space. Okay, even you can see that answer is not coming for this question. For printing answer we can use print answers command in the preamble. Again compile. Alright, now answer is coming. For any question you can leave a blank space using a vspace command. Okay, we can also provide empty box using make empty box command. In curly bracket just write the space. In addition, we can also provide blank space with several lines using a fill with lines command. Okay, here in curly bracket just write the space. Compile your file. Alright, we can also use fancy page style. Here we need to use three commands: page style, head and foot, header. There are three curly brackets. In the first curly bracket you can write your header which you want to print in the left side, this one for the center, and last one is for the right most, and then footer. Alright, in the next part we'll learn to add image. First I'll write question. Then just insert the image using include graphics command. Question marks we can also print in the right margin using points in right margin command. Okay, we can also use a square bracket rather than round bracket. For this we have to just use a bracketed points. We can also print a grid table using a grid table command. For printing grid table we also have to use add points command in the preamble. First column question, second column points, and third column score. We can easily format question label. For example, here I want to add a Q letter before the question number. So we can do this using a renew command. And here in the first curly bracket just write backslash question label. In the second curly bracket just write Q letter. And after that just use the question command. We can provide a small space using backslash comma. Okay. Alright. I'll write one more question without any instruction, which will have two parts. As you can see that here the left alignment of each part is not correct. We can correct this using llap command. So here just use backslash llap, and in the curly bracket just use Q letter. Okay. Alright. We can print a solution or answer for each question. After question just write begin solution, end solution. I'll give some examples. Alright, as you can see that answers are coming. We can remove the frame using unframed solutions command. Okay. If you don't want to print solution, then just remove the print answers command from the preamble. Okay. In the next part, we will format this paper. This paper has four sections. Section A, short answer questions. Section B, multiple choice questions. Section C, true, false and fill in the blanks questions. And section D, long answer questions. Okay. So we'll see this in the next part. Till then, bye bye. Thanks for watching.